Starting in 3, 2, 1, go. No space left on device. You can hear birds chirping and raindrops hitting leaves as the expedition proceeds. Occasionally you can even hear much louder sounds in the distance. How big do the animals get out here anyway? The device the elves gave you has problems with more than just its communication systems. You try to run a system update. No space left on the device. You can delete some files to make a space for the update. You browse around the file system to assess the situation and save the resulting terminal output, your puzzle input. For example, okay, we CD, we LS, and then we get directories and files. CD means change directory, moves in one level, CD dot dot moves out one level, CD slash switches the current directory to the outermost directory, LS means list. Dir and count. Okay. You need to determine the total size of each directory. Total size of a directory is the sum of the sizes of the files it contains, directly or indirectly. Directories themselves do not count as having any intrinsic size. Total sizes of the directories above can be found as follows, blah, blah, blah. Find all the directories with a total size of at most 100,000, then calculate the sum of their total sizes. Okay. Cool. Print part 1s. Split lines. List head x and lines. All right, so that's what we got. 1,000 lines of input. Do 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 do. All right, so we're gonna have our type dir state equals we are going to have current. Okay, well, let's think about this a little bit more. So we're going to get a list of directories, and then the files in it. Okay. Unclear whether or not we'll need the file names. We have a type file equals int. A type dir, which is a name string string files file list dir subdirs dir list parent dir option. How the heck do you declare a colons. Let's get rid of that. Okay. All right, so we have a file, a directory, and then a then we have a let's do this. Type command input line equals CD of string LS LS dir of string or file LS file of file. Do 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 do. Total size will be a mutable. Yeah, all of these things are mutable. In option. Okay, so let parse input equals let string dot split lines input list dot map f on line if line prefix string dot prefix string dot prefix CD two. Okay, if string dot prefix line one equals then if line equals us. Else if string.prefix equal string.prefix line one. Then cd equals string dot drop prefix line 5. CD of else if string dot equal prefix line 4 dir, then ls dir string dot drop prefix line 4 else size name equal in name size ls file sn okay driving to string and then can I do this equals parse input in list.editor print end line list.take 10 file all right let's look this up OCaml sucks string arriving. Do, 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 do. Print s sexp. All right, does it work? Nope. Open util. Okay, so we have vcd to root ls, and then we have a dir results, and then a file. Okay. Let. Let crawl state type equals root is a dir. Current dir is a dir. Yeah. Let root equals name root parent none module dir. File.t instruction yes, I do use OCaml at work, but I just started a new job recently, and so I don't know it very well, which is why I am doing stuff in OCaml. I work at Jane Street, where we use it for everything. Financial. It's a trading firm. Unbound constructor. Not previously. Yeah, I got a lot of problems right now. Name equals name, parent none. Files subdirs total size none. But root equals dir dot create root none. In that is the REPL environment. Dir.create. There we go. Okay. But root. Let crawl deriving sucks. Crawl state equals root. Crawl Perfect. Does that still work? How do I refer to this? Do I do crawl state dot? Does that work? Okay, interesting. So I don't need that. So now I can do this. Let's see. Sexp, OCaml, ignore field. Rules, records. How do I do this? Sexp dot opaque. Does that work? So now I don't want to see the parent. Shows up. Stands for S expression. Okay. So now I can process all of these instructions. Match. Inst with. CD. Dest. Let's do this. ls does nothing. ls dir. And ls file. So if we have ls file, then crawl state dot let crawl state dot currenter in current dir.files. Current dir dot subdirs. Let subdir equals dir dot create. Current dir in subdir current dir dot subdirs. LS does nothing. CD does nothing. Match dest with crawl state dot current dir is crawl state dot root crawl state dot current. Option dot value x in of current dir dot parent. Subdir. Current dir list dot find. Xin current dir dot dir subdirs f subdir subdir string dot equal subdir dot name. That okay. Current dir. Some. Parent. Oh, so I have to put this first. There we go. Let's see how that works. Not a lot of subdirs getting added. Interesting. Let's try this with a smaller input. With this input. So it looks like this root has c dot dat and b dot txt, got those, and then as subdirs has d and a. D has four files. Wait. So root does have this subdir A, which has this subdir F, or has this file F, and then has a subdir E. There's just a lot of files. Oh, that's why, I think. There we go. Now this will be closer. Now this will have everything. Okay, so we have c dot dat b dot txt. D has j has these four files. A has three files, and then the subdir E. Perfect. All working correctly. And now we want to compute this size. Let compute total size sizes root equals let size of files equals list dot sum int root dot files f file dot size in root dot total size sum size of files of subdirs equals list dot sum module int root dot subdirs subdir compute total size subdir. In that total of files plus size of there we go. Dot compute total size of root Okay, let's go. And then I want flatten ders equals root. List dot concat okay, and so now I want to flatten everything. So if I concat a list of lists, okay, it should include itself. Root let flattened subdirs equals list dot concat map root dot subdirs f un subdir flatten dirs subdir in dir dot flatten dirs root flattened dir dot t list. Does this work? So I get the root and then D and then A and then E. Cool. So I think that did work. Let bigger than small dirs equals dir list dot filter small dir size, whatever. Small ders flattened. D dot total option dot value xn size is greater than is less than in let some small dir sizes equals list dot sum module int small dirs. Some small dir sizes. Mm-hmm. 95437 is what I should get for perfect. Woohoo! 47 minutes, yikes. Now you're ready to choose a directory to delete. The total disk space available to the system is 70 million. You need unused space of at least 30 million. You need to find a directory you can delete that will free up enough space to run that update. Okay, so let used space equals option dot value xn of root needed space that total space equals 70. Let free space equals total space minus use space. Let dirs less dirs big enough dirs to delete equals greater equal to needed space in smallest dir to delete equals list min map dirs to delete. In print part two, smallest dir to delete total size. 2, 4, 9, 3, 3. Perfect. Woohoo! All right, let's talk through it now. This one was a little bit longer. But not too bad. So what we got going on here is we have a simple file directory structure thing. Recursive tree-like structure. So I made these files that have the name of the file and the size of the file. That's just a simple record. And then we have a directory, which has a name. It has a parent directory. And then it has a list of files, a list of subdirectories, and then also a total size, which is basically just a cached value. Then what we do is have this little helper to create a new directory, optionally with a parent, that'll just be default to none. Initializes these things to empty arrays, empty lists. Yeah. So the way we parse these, the input, which looks like this, is I made this instruction. This instruction record type that is either changing into a directory, listing a directory, showing a directory result from the ls, or showing a subdirectory, or a file in that directory along with the size. And so I parse these. If it's $ls, then it's an ls instruction. If it starts with cd, then we drop that prefix to get the directory name. If it starts with dir, we drop that to get a dir name. And then otherwise we use scanf to pull out the size and name of a list, of a file, and then create a ls file. So then, this whole crawl state isn't really necessary. Yeah, we don't really need that. But current dir equals root. Root does that still work? Mm-hmm. Okay, I just got rid of this extra crawl state that wasn't really doing anything. So we get the instructions, we create our root directory, it's fine, name for it. And then we keep track of our current directory the whole time. And then as we loop over everything, if it's a CD instruction, if it's CD to slash, we update our current directory to the root. If it's dot dot, we set it to the current directory's parent. Otherwise, if it's a subdomain, we find that subdirectory in the list of subdirectories, in the current directory's subdirectories. If it's an ls instruction, we don't do anything. If we get a directory as a result of an ls, we create the subdirectory with the parent set to the current directory, and then add that to the list of subdirectories. And if it's a file, we add that to the list of files for the current directory. Then we compute the total sizes of the root. So I'll go back to this. To compute the size of a directory, we sum up all of the file sizes. Then we sum up all of the subdirectory sizes by recursively calling compute total size of the subdirectory, add those two together, set that in the root total size, and then get it out. So we compute the size of everything, then we actually just want a list of all of the directories. So then this flat endures thing, you pass it a list of directories, and then it flattens all of its subdirectories and concats them together, and then you concat that with the I could just do root flattened subdirs. That should work just as well. Yep. So then we flatten everything, and then we get the small directory. For part one, we want to find the sum of the directory, sum of the sizes of the directories less than 100. A hundred thousand bytes, less than or equal. And then we just sum those up. And then for part two, we have a certain amount of total space. We've used a certain amount of space that's taken up by the root. We have some amount of free space then, which is 70,000 minus how much is used. And then we need a certain amount of space, which is 30 million bytes minus how much free space we have. And so then the dirs, we could delete, I guess this is could delete. We select the lists, the dirs that have the size greater than or equal to the needed space, and then we just get the minimum of that, and that is the answer. Yeah.